It's great to be here with you today. I'm really excited to join you and talk a little bit about the new graph APIs that we're releasing for advanced eDiscovery. My name is Nick Robinson, and I'm a program manager on the Microsoft 365 security and compliance team. And really, I'm focused on eDiscovery and investigations. And one of the key things that we've been hearing from customers as they adopt advanced eDiscovery is, hey, we really need some API support to help support automation integration. So I'm really excited to share with you today the progress that we've made on this front and a little bit about how this is going to show up for you and the experience you'll have. So what we have planned for today is let's quickly cover the customer challenges, what we're hearing from our customer organizations, kind of where they are, what they're grappling with in today's world. And then let's go a little bit just so that we're all on the same page into advanced eDiscovery. Set the context on what the solution is about, how it's getting utilized today, and then we'll go directly into the new graph API scenarios that we have set up. We'll do a quick demo to show you how to quickly get started, how to get your team started on orienting themselves around the graph, understanding the compliance APIs, and then starting to utilize some of these, testing them out via the Explorer and building some sample apps. And then finally, we'll do a quick look ahead to look at what's next, because we're not done yet. Of course, we're going to continue to innovate and deliver more here. And so we want to give you a sneak peek into what you'll see coming over the next few months towards the end of the year. So that's the plan. So let's go ahead and jump in. And I wanted to quickly, you know, start off by saying, hey, this is a interesting year, an interesting Ignite. You know, it's great to be here with you, no matter the context and the format. You know, I'm here in my home office, and I suspect many of you are as well. I'm coming up on 6 months now of kind of working remotely from the home office. And, you know, it's been great. It's been challenging at times. There's pros and cons. You know, you might hear some playful laughter or some shrieking in the background, and that's one of those pros and the cons. But one of the really cool things is that we've seen that the technology is able to stand up to this massive test. And we're really able to engage, work with, collaborate, and really do a lot of the things that we're used to doing in the normal workplace context now remotely. And so, of course, this remote context is creating a new interesting dynamic around digital transformation and the progress our customers are taking into the cloud. And with this, kind of continues some of the trends that we've already seen. And so the first trend is, hey, data is exploding. The volume, the variety, the velocity of data in your organization is going through the roof. And we're seeing that across the board. And so this is great because there's kind of new ways of working, new file formats, new attachments, all these different ways of kind of helping get things done more smoothly, more effectively. But then that also poses some challenge. The remote work kind of being an underlying foundation of that as well. And so we hear customers kind of more and more saying, hey, how am I going to manage this in a compliant way? And so as the volume increases, the complexity of the regulations and your compliance requirements, of course, are not decreasing. And even further, there's probably pressure to do more with less. Security and compliance is more critical than ever for organizations today. But in fact, we need to be more effective and be able to get more done with less resources overall. So we think about that regulatory complexity. The landscape is constantly changing. The regulations are getting updated on a regular basis. And what we hear from our customers is, hey, we need help. We need help on working through this. We need new ways to discover this content to make it fast and easy to help get these things, these regulatory requests responded to, these investigations move forward. A lot of these are time-sensitive activities. And when you're looking at vast quantities of data, it makes it even more important that you're able to pinpoint with precision the relevant content that you want. So then when we go into the eDiscovery context specifically, some of the things that we're seeing out in the market are around, hey, investigations are growing. The number of investigations companies are running is growing year over year. And then the regulations and legal requests are time bound. And so the expectation is that I'm turning around this request on a very short term. And that's really critical is that I meet these deadlines and I'm able to do that effectively. And so when you think about the traditional method that organizations have used here, it's collect broad swaths of information, probably more data than you need, and export it and get it out so that you can handle it and process it and move it downstream. And what we're hearing from customers is, I don't want to do that. I don't want to take all this content out of the Microsoft 365 compliance boundary anymore. I want to have my sensitive content in one place, ensure that it's safe and protected there, and not have to worry about these multiple repositories. And further, users are collaborating in different new ways. So Teams, Yammer, chat-based workspace, this is all creating new kind of different dynamics of the content that needs to be at your fingertips when you need it. So when we think about advanced eDiscovery and where this solution is in the market and what we see from customers so far, this is really about collecting and discovering data where it is. So you're in the Microsoft 365 cloud, you've got close access to Exchange, SharePoint, the various workloads that make up the data repositories, whether they're custodial owned locations or shared locations like groups or teams or sites. And so that ability to be close to that source and collect and start to bring it together in place really improves your process and enables you to iterate much more quickly. Secondarily, we're all about enabling workflows right in Microsoft 365. So if you think about legal hold notifications requirements and the mandate of letting folks know within litigation when they're on hold, this is something that we support. Custodian management. This is a key piece to identify and preserve relevant content. That's also now a capability in advanced eDiscovery. So we're really working to extend the workflows and complete more of that EDRM model for our customers who are thinking about eDiscovery in the cloud. And then third, and this is where there's a really high value feature set where we're able to intelligently cull and reduce the data before you start to do anything else with it. So you can take out the duplicates, take out the threads, just get rid of that stuff that's just going to clog the amount of data that you have as a part of this case. And then you can start to do themes and clustering and start to do some tagging where you can say this is relevant or not relevant, even using some of our smart ML models to automatically remediate things that are attorney-client privilege, for example. And so with that, you can vastly reduce the relevant content within your case so that when you're ready to go and kind of handle that case content for production and either hand it to HR or hand it to opposing counsel, it's only the minimal set that's responsive, the most critical data, the smallest amount of data. And that's going to save you a ton of money and risk as you think about how much data do I need to take out of my environment. So that's what advanced eDiscovery is all about. It's getting some great traction with some of our customers on adopting and bringing this to the foreground now so that they can do more in the cloud. As I mentioned, one of the feedbacks that we've seen so far with this adoption is, hey, I really need a way to automate this. I need a way to take some of these tasks that are manual and repetitive and make them kind of more streamlined and repeatable. And so what we're excited to share with you today is that we have a new set of graph APIs that are now available in public preview, and they're really set up around delivering on two scenarios for our customers. We want them to help deliver automation, and this is really all about automating those common processes. So jobs and tasks that you're used to doing in advanced eDiscovery, you can now write an app to call the API to do it automatically for you. And this is huge because one, it reduces the amount of repetitive tasks that your staff are doing in the solution, but two, it also makes the process more repeatable, predictable, and consistent, which is hugely important when you think about the eDiscovery workflow. So this is a way that you can mitigate that potential human error that does arise and increase with the repetitiveness of tasks over time. And so this is a huge part where we're able to help increase that predictability. The second piece that's really important is around integration. So we think about organizations that need custom solutions to complete the last part of their workflows, or they need integration with existing systems, either something they've built on their own or an existing solution that they picked up off the shelf, for example, matter management. And we'll look at an example where I can connect to my management system and kick off a whole workflow within advanced eDiscovery. And so that integration really reduces the isolation of the advanced eDiscovery platform and the Microsoft cloud. And this is something we've been hearing from customers, really excited to get it into your hands and see the kind of stuff you do with it. So before we go into looking at the specific demo and the walk through the flow, let's take a look at the scenario that we think might be relevant for a lot of organizations. And so in this example, we've got a global retail company. They've got a lot of surface area around the globe, and they're seeing an increasing number of investigations, HR-related investigations, whether it's harassment, things like that within the workplace. And so as this number of these is growing, there's kind of a drive to more standardize and make this more automated. And so in this case, what we're suggesting is that, hey, the app devs in the organization, you find out who in the organization has experience with Microsoft Graph, or you find some dev team that's able to start to learn Microsoft Graph. And what they're going to be able to do is write an app that connects a matter management system in this case, because this organization is kicking off investigations on a regular basis. And what that app can then do is then connect into Advanced eDiscovery and trigger an action, whether it's create that case and add all the metadata and details that are related to that case right into Advanced eDiscovery, or really any of the circles along this path are going to be things that you can engage with via the API. So I could create the case, I could add the correct custodians if I know the department and the individuals that might be related to this particular investigation. If there's shared data resources, I can configure those, create that hold to preserve that content, collect that content, add it to review set that it's at, so that it's at my fingertips and I can start to review it, run those advanced analytics that we talked about to reduce that overall data set with themes and deduplication. And then I can even do queries into my review set where I do additional refiners around specific word choices, context, specific ways that I want to understand that set of content. And once I've got the tags set up within the review set, which I can also automate, then my reviewer, my in-house reviewer, my legal team is ready to start to take a look. And this is where the humans come back into the process. They're going to take some review while your content's still in place within the Microsoft 365 compliance boundary and validate that, hey, this is the right stuff for this request, for this investigation, and then put the check mark to say, hey, we're ready to export this for further downstream production. And so all of this now can become automated through these various API calls that will be available. And so we really encourage you to look at the first set, you know, to start to look at it, to see what scenarios are going to be relevant for you and how your organization can start to take advantage of this. So if we step forward, you know, what we wanted to do in this session was we realized that there's probably a number of IT pros, IT DMs that are decision makers that are coming to the session, and they might not be the people who actually do the development work of the apps themselves. And so we wanted to kind of chart a path, give a bit of a roadmap on where you should go to get started, what you need to do. We have four chunks here that we're going to go through in the next few minutes. And the first one is really around familiarize yourself and your dev, so find your app dev partner, wherever that might be in your organization, or if you need to bring someone from outside your organization to help with that, or maybe yourself. I mean, it is not too difficult to learn this stuff, but you do want to have someone who's going to be able to get ready and start writing that simple app. So get yourself and your dev partner familiar with Microsoft Graph broadly. Now, there's some really cool things about this because it's a platform, so it's not just going to benefit you in this context, and then go into the compliance APIs specifically. Now, from there, we recommend you dive into the Graph Explorer and start to validate the calls that are available. See what the expectations are for what you're going to get back. How can you use that to start to build your sample app? Once you have a good handle on how that's going to look, then you can start to put some specs together. Talk to some of your stakeholders, gather some requirements. What are the most important scenarios that we need to light up now? And then what's our tail of scenarios that we want to go after later? And from there, develop that app and start to iterate. And we'll show you a quick app that we threw together as a team to start to show this process and illuminate the art of the possible. So as we go forward here, then, you know, that first piece is go to the graph, understand the graph, and there's great documentation. You can see we just got a screenshot of the overview of the Microsoft Graph here. Down the side, there's tons of different content that I can engage with. And what this does is it gives me a really good sense for that platform. What's that value that's going to be cohesive across the different applications in Microsoft 365 that are going to serve different scenarios and requirements for different parts of my organization? Super critical. And let me just jump into the demo for a second, and I'll show you how this looks actually in the browser so that everybody's on the same page. So I've got my overview of the Microsoft Graph here, tons of content, some really important things around authorization. So you're going to need to make sure that the person who's going to be doing this has the correct authorization and permissions to the app that they want to develop against. So that's a super critical component. And I wanted to kind of quickly call out the overview content. So as I mentioned, getting familiar with the platform has a ton of benefits because once you know about the Microsoft Graph, you're going to be able to use it in a bunch of different ways, not just for eDiscovery. So learn about what this means. Understand there's a ton of information here. There's a change log, there's what's new highlights. The graph team has done a phenomenal job bringing this all together. So take a look, make sure you dive into that. The next piece is once you familiarize yourself, go into the compliance portion of the graph documentation specifically. So here I want to highlight, hey, we're in the beta reference section of the documentation, and go down to compliance preview and you can get an overview. And then you can start to take a look at the different calls that are available within the eDiscovery portion. So I'm reading my overview, I've got a sense of what's going on here, and then I want to dive into each of these. And so within case, I can see, hey, I have a number of options. I've got list, get, create, update, delete. I've got a similar set of nodes for eDiscovery review set and then also review set query. These are just the first. There's more coming. So we make sure to check back over time and there'll be more added here as they come online. But this is where you're going to want to start to take a look and validate what is going on and understand what's available now that you can start to iterate with. Then the next step I'd recommend is you jump over to Graph Explorer, and your dev partner, the person who's working on this, is going to have to authenticate in into this Graph Explorer using their Office 365 credentials, and they must have the same permissions to advance eDiscovery to let them do these things. But what I can see is, hey, I've got a set of getting started, but if I scroll down, I've also got this set of compliance betas. And now what this is going to let me do is auto set these so that I can start to run these, and it will update, hey, I want this review sets, or let's say in this case, I want to get the list of eDiscovery cases. It's going to set this for me to beta, and I can just run that query. And now I can start to quickly validate what this response is going to give me so that I can start to set expectations and start to scope and spec how I'm going to build my new app with the data that this API is able to return to me based on that call. So you can see it's a quick JSON output, and it's breaking down kind of what are these different cases, because I asked for a list of my eDiscovery cases. So this starts to show you that now you can start to validate for each of those calls, kind of what am I going to get returned to me that I could utilize within my app. And then from there, once you validate that, we want to make sure that you feel supported as you go through this process. There's this fantastic tutorial, ASP.NET MVC, that's going to take you from one end of the process to the other end to get you started with a simple app. You know, this is like a not that long of a tutorial. You can see the whole component parts here, but this is a place where you can quickly learn by doing and be guided in each step as you go through. So this is a critical piece that I recommend that you take some time to go through with both you and also your developer for this. And then at the outcome, you know, we actually went through this as a team just to pull together a view to show you kind of the art of the possible. And we threw together this simple app based on a case report. So how many cases am I opening over time? Now, this is super simple, seems really basic, but actually can be super valuable because then that helps the organization load balance, plan their resources, look ahead, understand are things trending up? Are they trending down? How should I think about this capability in terms of my load and my budget for moving forward? And can I validate that my investigations really are growing and I should invest in automating some of these processes? So this super simple view threw together relatively quickly, but just to show an example of how this is all going to work, helps bring home the particular point that this is a simple thing you can get started with now in a kind of a narrow specific way, and then expand over time as we build out the rest of the APIs that are available and you build your capacity as an organization. So then just to go back to next steps and kind of wrap things up real quick, we have, you know, a view of how we're going to continue to develop and what's next. So what's available today you can take a look at, and then what we're working on is this full list here, and then finally what's coming after that point. And you know, we're really glad that you're able to join us today for this session. What we want to leave you with is the first set's available now. Go get started. We'd love to see what you're doing. Give us feedback. We'd love to hear from you. We'll continue to roll out these APIs through Q3 and Q4 into production availability by the end of Q4 2020. And then check out the rest of the compliance sessions. There's a ton of great content and sessions that are all taking place. If you are a dev or you have a dev partner, we have a full 30-minute breakout session on this topic in the Microsoft Graph platform track. Be sure to check it out. It's really great to chat with you today. Really glad you came. Drop me a line, nickrob@microsoft.com. Would love to continue the discussion and hope you have a great Ignite. Thank you so much.